I am so jealous of this little one right here. He is eating Icy's plain and fancy ice cream. It's so rich and delicious. It's just ridiculous. We also have Tom Halaska here from Des Moines Oyster Bar. Let's start with Max Cracks from Icy's Plain and Fancy. And we're trying to make sure that we take care of the dogs, not just here in St. Louis, but also in Texas too. Is
that's
that right?
Right. We put me and Tom have put the drive together. Basically, we're bringing a bunch of supplies down for disaster relief for fur babies and babies. Yeah. What we're doing right now with the Sticky Charlie ice creams, our doggy ice cream that we serve at the shop.
He is tearing it up, by the way.
And as always, $2 of it goes to Stray Rescue here in St. Louis.
Uh-huh.
But for the month of September, the other $2 will go straight to disaster relief in Houston.
Oh, and what are you hearing about the plight of animals who are Hurricane Harvey survivors?
There's a whole lot of animals that are, you know, separated from their homes that couldn't go, you know, with their families for whatever reason. I know Stray Rescue just took in about 20 dogs.
Okay.
So there's a lot of need for different products to take care of them and keep the shelters full.
Okay, so those are our fur babies. Tom Halaska, Des Moines Oyster Bar, tell us about the human babies.
Same thing, lots of newborn babies that don't have diapers. Diapers are a huge expense for families.
Yeah.
So I figured that'd be something we could help out with diapers and also feminine hygiene products as well.
Okay.
Which is also, with the organizations that we're dealing with, the Houston Diaper Bank, as requested those particular items.
There's a whole diaper bank down there.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good to know. But I think that's something that a lot of people don't think about on a good day, much less when you're trying to fight for your life, right?
Right, exactly, right. And what we're trying to do is collect specific supplies that meet specific needs. And I think that the babies and fur babies really plays into that.
Now something else, Max, you guys are not the only two restaurants that are helping out with this, are you?
No, what's happened has been really great. There's like almost 50 restaurants now that are participating as drop spots.
Yeah.
If you get on the Facebook page, which is
it's Babies and Fur Babies, on Facebook.
Yes. And there's a complete list there. Everything gets dropped off, and then you know the nice thing about this is it's all going straight there. We are literally driving it.
You guys are driving it down.
Yep.
Wow. Yeah. Okay.
We know it's all going to get there. You know, so that's
that's a good point because a lot of people are concerned about that. Do you guys have like an 18 wheeler, a bunch of cars?
We're going to drive the U-Hauls down.
Wow.
Yeah. Yep.
That is a commitment. So. I mean, I don't know. This, I guess, kind of staying back here kind of feels kind of helpless, but you guys are obviously empowering a lot of people, right?
Absolutely. And then the restaurant community, it speaks volumes in St. Louis and what we're able to accomplish. It was a couple of phone calls and a couple of emails, and we've got 50-plus restaurants who are all working together to collect these supplies and get them down to Texas.
Yeah, in just a few days here, we've already got truckloads, just tons of supplies in. But we still need more. You know, as much as we can take, we're going to take. So.
All right, everybody, just jump on Facebook and go to Babies and Fur Babies to find out if your favorite restaurant is helping out babies and fur babies who are Hurricane Harvey survivors. And everybody, just remember, helping someone change their life, continue to survive and thrive is as easy as eating at your favorite restaurant here on the 9 a.m. show.